fusible web or heat and seal. This is a fantastic double-sided glue fabric which you can attach one fabric to another really easily. And there's different weights, so you can have light, ultra hold or very fine. This is the ultra, so it's a film. That's the fusible bit. I've cut the paper away. This is the light, the heat and seal light. As you can see, it's a grid, so it's not an all-over glue. And this is the web, which name it says exactly what it is. So they all do the same job, but they will attach fabric to fabric more securely or less securely, depending on what you want. This will be less secure because it's light. This is great if you're going to work with heavyweight fabrics, even such things as leathers or cardboard, you can use that. And this is a nice fine one, so it's perfect for appliques. So this is the fusible web, and I can feel the webbing on the reverse of the paper here. It feels rougher, and if you can catch a sheen, there's a slight sheen to it. So I turn it over and place the web side down on the reverse of my fabric that I'm going to cut out my appliques from. And just iron that on there. So I'm fusing that glue side to the back of the fabric. 2 or 3 seconds is all you need. Allow it to cool down a little bit before you handle it, because obviously it is hot. And then you can cut the pattern that you want out of your fabric. In fact, I can, of course, cut from the right side because it's all fused in place. And I'm actually cutting around a design. And when you're cutting around an existing design, you don't have to laboriously go around every single little notch and groove. You can smooth them out a bit, because what you're going to be doing afterwards, having fused this to your main fabric, you're going to stitch around the outer edges and hold it all in place permanently. So having cut around my roses, I can then position them on my base fabric, decide where I want them to be, move them around, do whatever I like. And once I've made a decision of how I want to have them, I peel away the paper backing. So now all that's left is the glue on the back of the flower. And then cover with a press cloth, because I'm now going to work on the right side of the fabric and I don't want to damage the fabric at all. Cover with a press cloth and iron for about 10 seconds. So they're now fused in place, ready for me to sew. But again, I'm going to allow them to cool. But you don't just have to work with ready-made flowers. You can actually create your own designs. So on this piece, I've fused the heat and seal on the back of the fabric again, and I've drawn some flowers. And again, I can just cut around the flowers, and then they'll be ready to fuse onto the other fabric by taking away the paper backing. It's a lot easier if you fuse the heat and seal or the fusible web onto the fabric you're going to use as your applique before cutting out the shape. If you do it the other way around, it just makes it more difficult to actually fuse it. So these are now ready, so I can peel away the paper backing. And again, I can stick them onto my main fabric wherever I want them. I haven't decided on the position. Take the paper backing off, fuse them in place. Of course, you don't have to just draw flowers. So again, I've fused the heat and seal to the back of the fabric. This is the paper backing. I've drawn a boat shape. I've also done some numbers. Now, if you're doing numbers or letters, you have to write them in reverse on the back, because when you then turn them over to fuse onto your main fabric, they will then be the right way round. I've just cut my boat out. And I'm now ready to fuse everything in position on my base fabric. I have my base. Peel off the paper backing. That's my boat. I can put on my sails. I've already taken the paper backing off of these. And you can put on the numbers or whatever else you want, the lettering, if you want to name your boat. Cover the whole lot with a press cloth and fuse in place for about 10 seconds. And I've got the iron set onto wool or to moderate. So that's now ready to be stitched around. And there's a choice of the way you do the stitching. On this little one, I've done free motion stitching. So I've dropped the feed dogs on the sewing machine and put on the free motion foot and just stitched roughly round the edge to give it that sort of naive look. And that just anchors it all down. Remember, it is already fused in place. Or you can do a satin stitch around the edges, which is actually a zigzag stitch with the length closed right down to about 0.35 or 0.40.